Hello everyone, welcome to your 21st Grasshopper tutorial. In this tutorial we're going to talk about the graph mapper and how to work with graph mappers and understanding how graph mappers work. So the thing is, I really didn't want to do this tutorial because I know that there's a million other tutorials talking about graph mappers. But the thing is, I have a system and I wanted it to be like a series, and there's an order to the tutorials I'm going to make, so I really wanted to make sure that my tutorials are covering all the aspects of Grasshopper before we actually go into maybe more complex tutorials later on. So yeah, for now we're going to learn about the graph mapper in Grasshopper. So first thing we're going to do is construct a point. So if you just type in conpt, you get construct point. And by default, the point's location is on 0, 0, 0. So your point is, the x axis is going to be 0, the y is 0, and the z is 0. Now if you get the graph mapper, so type in graph mapper, you're going to notice we have like this square and there's nothing inside and there's like a warning sign. The thing is, if you connect this to the y, you also need a number. So if you just double click and type in 1.00, you'll have a number slider. And I'll just explain in a minute why I chose this number in particular. Okay, so what we see now is just a point, which if we move it like this, now by default there's no graph. So if we just right click, go to graph types, we can see that the default is none. Now we can choose a bunch of like graph types you want. So let's say I want the sine graph. So we can see actually is that if you move your slider, you're going to notice there's like a red line, and this red line intersects with your graph. So this is your graph and this is your red line. So wherever this graph intersects with your red line, you have a number. This is the number that's coming out of your graph map, and then it's feeding it into your x-axis or whatever number you want. So you need two things for the graph mapper. You need a number before the graph mapper, or a bunch of numbers. And you need to connect it to whatever you want these numbers, like whatever you want to happen to these numbers. So if you double click and type in panel and connect it. Okay, so if you just, by default, when you have, when you have a number in Grasshopper, by default, your numbers are linear. What linear means is like it's set to an order, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, something like that. But with the graph mapper, you can actually have a formula. Now, if you went to high school, I'm pretty sure there's like a million formulas, like the sine and the cosine and stuff like that. And with that, you can have graphs with these formulas. Now, what you're saying is just like, take my number, put it inside the formula, and check where the intersection is and give me a new number based on the formula. So what you also notice with this is that this is one unit. So you have 0, 1 and then 1, 0, 1. This is 0, 1 for the x-axis and this 0, 1 for the y-axis. So this whole thing is just one unit. Now, as you can notice that this one unit is just, the range is a bit small. So there's two ways to actually increase the range of this graph mapper. The first way is if you just double click and you go here to your graph editor, you can see at the x you can just double click and type in 10 and maybe the y 10, and you can notice that here is like 0.10 and you're seeing 0.10. So this is your graph exactly like we have it here, but the range is higher, so it's 10 10. Okay, so if you just leave it as it is, you can see that if I'm moving my slider now, it's just for one unit. And that makes sense because now our graph is now divided into 10. So how to fix this is just you delete this and then make 10, or even like 10.00, and you can see now your graph works much better and you can have better line intersection for your entire graph. So really have to be careful if you're changing the numbers here to make it like match the numbers you're feeding it into. The other way to do it, so if you just double click and change this back to default 1, hit OK, and change this also to 1, is what most people use, and that's the multiplication, which is like double click, type in multiplication, and then feed it to the A, and then get maybe a 10 for the B, and then connect the result to your X. So So now we see it does the same thing. This is just making your graph mapper smaller. And this is the location of your point on your graph mapper. Now the result here would be different. So if you just copy it, you can see that now it's 7.6 something. So this is your new number with the new graph. It got like 10 times bigger. So yeah, this is like two ways to make your graph mapper with a better range or bigger range. The other thing you want to know about the graph mapper is that usually most people don't use it for one number only. They use it for like a bunch of numbers. So if you just do the construct point again, and actually get the range this time. So double click, type in maybe, now to make, there's a different way to make a slider. So if like 10, less than 20, less than 50, you can have the lowest number to be 10, the highest to be 50, and it will stay at 20, or start at 20. So make this your domain, and make this your steps. Okay, so let's say I don't do the graph mapper, and just connect it to your X. Let's just delete this, hide this point. Okay, so these are your new set of points. So like what I said, it's very linear, so there's a form to it. If you get your graph mapper and connect it and then set the graph mapper, so like I said, by default there's null, which makes it almost linear, but if you just right click, go graph type, and then go to sign maybe, you can see that there's something happening, there's a change. Now, if you really want to see what's going on here, this is just changing the range through the graph mapper in a very small area here. And it's just giving you a bunch of numbers. So if you just go on panel, connect it, you can see that gave you a random set of like number locations in the x-axis for these number of points that you gave. So what they usually do is, if you want to see more than one result, it's better to keep one of them linear and the other one to change its to change it with a graph mapper. So all you have to do now is basically tweak it. If you don't like how it looks like, you want to add more steps, you want to make it bigger, you want to change your graph type into maybe sine. See what it looks like. Not so good. Yeah. So usually when you have something like this, you have to actually do the multiplication. You see people do, sometimes it works, makes it look better. Sometimes it doesn't. Okay, let me check if this works. Yeah, so now you see that now we have a bigger range, which is like multiplying every number that goes through this formula into like times 10, so we have a better range of numbers. Let's change this to sine. Nope. Yeah, I like this one. So you can see that these little circles are your control points, so you can actually control all the points which you have on your graph mapper. Okay. Yeah. So what else you can do with the graph mapper? You can okay, you can actually just copy this. So hit Alt and drag. You have a different copy. And then let's move your points. So now I have a moved point of it, but I'm sure that there's a copy. No? Okay. So moving your point upwards to the z-axis, let's say you want to change this graph mapper, so right click your graph types and go to sign. Now you see that we have a copy of it, which is normal. I expected it because move gives you a copy and it moves it at the same time. So we have to just hide one of them. So now we have these sets of points and these sets of points. Now because the range is equal for both graph mappers, you can see that we just double click and type in line and connect them both. It will connect each point to the other one. And you can actually have like a pipe if you want. There's no need for a pipe. Okay, so yeah, you can have like two graph mappers or two sets of points which you can manipulate them and make them look and like connect them together. Now another thing you can do, okay, is set your graph mapper to the Z and connect your range to the Y. And after you're done, see, so now we have this, the graph mapper, like, on the Z axis. If you just graph through X, like last tutorial we learned about graph, which is basically making each point in its own list, you're gonna have these sets of grids. I mean, like a grid kind of thing with all your points in it. Okay, so yeah, this is basically what the graph mapper is. It's just you have a certain number of points and you want them to go through a formula which you can see through a graph, and you can manipulate the graph with your control points, and then from there you're gonna have like a really nice set of numbers based on a certain formula. Now I've seen, I think, a tutorial where the guy makes it in a surface point. I think his name is Daniel something, I'm not sure. Anyway, I'm gonna put his link for his graph tutorial. I think it's really nice, and he did it actually in 3D. For me, I'm not gonna put the surface, I'm gonna do something else. So let's maybe try and then the lonely edges connect it. Yeah, and I have like a nice kind of truss kind of connection. Yeah, I think it looks cool too. We can just make this into pipes, and let me try making it into pipe, and we'll have like a nice result. No? Why not? Oh. Okay. So yeah, we're gonna have the result we wanted basically. Let's try. Whoops. So you're basically supposed to connect your edges and not your. I don't know, bigger points. So yeah, this is basically what a graph mapper is, and it's a pretty cool tool to like run your numbers through it. And yeah, it's an easy tool. So if you have any questions, please comment in the comment section below, and I'll see you next tutorial.